breaking updates from Kerala. After a lower court in Kerala acquitted former Bishop Franco Mullakkal in the nun rape case, the state police have now sought legal opinion. They are likely to move an appeal against the verdict in the High Court. This is the big breaking update that we're getting our viewers at this hour, where the Kerala court, after the Kerala court acquitted Franco Mullakkal in the nun rape case, the state police will now seek legal opinion and are likely to move an appeal against the verdict in the High Court as well. And for more on this, I'm joined by my colleague Vivek on the broadcast. Vivek, for the benefit of our viewers, can you take us through this latest decision by the Kerala police? Why are they doing this? And also give us a background of the case.
Yes, for the Kerala police or the prosecution of the government is concerned, this is a matter of prestige. Remember, they have been investigating this case right from 2018 onwards. Remember, this incident happened between 2014 and 16, 13 times. She says that she was being sexually assaulted. But observing, the court observed that there was no consistency in the victim's statement. The court said that the grievance projected by her to her companion sisters was that the accused was taking retaliatory steps for not yielding to his sexual desires, whereas her version before the court was that she was forced to sexual intercourse with the accused on 13 occasions. Now, what the court says is that the prosecution has clearly failed to give proper explanation for the inconsistent version. Now, it's a 289-page verdict that's been given out by G. Gopakumar, the additional session court judge. And this is something which even the legal luminaries in the country have expressed a shock. Hari Shankar, who is the former SP of Kottayam, has expressed shock. He said that this is a judgment which is even a miracle in the history of Indian judiciary. This is something which they didn't expect, because they say that they have put out all evidences, even the materialistic evidences, but the court says that the statements given by the survivor, that the victim in this case, is inconsistent. She at various points she has given different statements, and hence they cannot take that into cognizance, and that is the reason why the judge has acquitted Franco Mullakkal. Remember, he has been acquitted for all the 7 charges. Remember, the case was first, the nun has complained in 2018, at the police station in Kuravalangad in Kottayam, following which the police investigated prima facie. They found that she was sexually assaulted, and then this case was taken up in various courts. Even in the Kerala High Court, the issue was taken up at the point of time, and the Bishop, Franco Mullakkal, did not get a favorable kind of verdict at that point of time. But later, the court, the case which was pending in the session court, that was a judgment which came yesterday. Everyone was expecting a judgment in favor of the survivor, because even the investigation team at various points has put out various evidences in this case. But the verdict was totally different. Now what we understand is that the team will be approaching the Kerala High Court against Franco Mullakkal. Back to you.
Yes. All right, Vivek, thank you so much for getting us all those updates. Let's also get in a word from the National Commission for Women, where the NCW chief Rekha Sharma has expressed her concerns at the verdict by the lower court in the nun rape case. The NCW chief said that she is shocked at the judgment. She also added that if the victim needs any kind of legal aid to appeal this order, to challenge. Meanwhile, Mirror Now has accessed the judgment copy in the case. In the 289-page verdict, the court said that there is no corroborative evidence submitted by the prosecution to prove that the case and that there was an exaggeration in the statements of the victim. It further added that the prosecution had failed to produce any corroborative evidence besides the victim's statement. Meanwhile, my colleague Sherin spoke to the lawyer of Franco Mullakkal, Raman Pillai. He highlighted that the order copy states that there is no conspiracy in the victim's, that there is no consistency, I beg your pardon, in the victim's statement.
Copy, on what basis has the court decided, came up with this verdict?
Mainly, court has decided the case because court cannot, on the basis of materials, court could not believe the victim. The story was disbelieved.
Okay.
Full of contradictions, and is not corroborated by any evidence. And she has been doing something else. That the evidence given by her is not a true satisfaction. And she is not a standing witness. There's nothing to corroborate her testimony. But the evidence used by the prosecution during cross-examination was found to be against what is stated by her before court.
All right. We are seeing that there were 87 witnesses. The charge sheet was about 1,400 pages. Do you think it was a botched up case by the Kerala police in this matter?
Kerala police investigation was not up to the mark.
Okay.
That appears to be faulty. Because they are also helpless.